हाय, एंड देन नेक्स्ट कंटिन्यूशन पार्ट फॉर क्लासेस क्लासेस ऑफ IP4। सो लेट्स सी वन सिंपल नेटवर्क। अज्यूम दैट दिस इज वन नेटवर्क, दिस इज वन नेटवर्क। अज्यूम इट्स नेटवर्क आईडी इज 192.168.1। सी इफ आई टेक 192.168.1.1, सो हाउ कैन आई नो दिस आईपी एड्रेस इज बिलोंग्स टू विच क्लास, एज वी डिस्कस्ड इन अर्लियर वीडियो। इफ यू वी विल टेक दिस रेंज 192, 192 इज कम्स अंडर क्लास सी, सो दिस इज द क्लास सी एड्रेस, सो दैट यू कैन से दैट दिस इज नेटवर्क पार्ट एंड दिस इज होस्ट पार्ट। मीन्स इन दिस पर्टिकुलर नेटवर्क फर्स्ट टू होस्ट, होस्ट नंबर वन, यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट होस्ट नंबर वन। सो इन दिस नेटवर्क दिस पर्टिकुलर आईपी एड्रेस वी आर सेइंग, सो ऑल टुगेदर 192.168.1.1। सो दिस इज वन काइंड ऑफ नेटवर्क। सो व्हाइल मेंशनिंग द नेटवर्क we will write only network part, and inside the network we will write the only host part. So if you take this address 150.157, inside some address 10.10, why here two, why here two octants outside, why two octants inside, and three octants outside, one octant is inside. So you take this one 150.157.10.10. This is actually the IP address. Like while posting a letter, you will write some address. So in that address, they will go hierarchically. So state, under the state which district, under the district which mandal, then under the mandal which village, then inside the village which house. Same like here also, only here we have only two parts, network ID and host ID. Then what is the network part here? So how we will extract that? So we will extract by taking, considering the first octant. First octant here is 150, so it's comes under class B. So if it is a class B address, in class B address first two octants you are using for network ID, so that's why 150.157 is here in the network portion. This is representing whole this network. Then inside this network, this particular address, this particular system you are talking about, so that's why this is the inside the computer, inside the system number. So now assume that like this you have one more network. Let's take this is as a 10.1.1.1. So in this case 10.1.1, so this is what 10 comes under, it's a, if this range comes under class A, so in the class A first octant is for network part and remaining is for host part. So that's why here 10 dot is you are representing the total network, and remaining address you are taking as a computer address, so system address or host address. So this is also taken as 210.15.15.4. assume that to connect the all these are the different networks. To connect these networks, you need a one medium unit, one connector unit, that is called router. So networks are different, networks are connecting to this router, and assume that this direction, interface A direction, you are going to 192.168.1 network, interface B direction you are going to 210.15.15 interface C direction we are going to here, interface D direction we are going to in this direction. So here the thing is, every router will maintain one routing table whenever any packet is reached to this router, to which direction it have to be forward. So to take that decision, you need something to think. So that here is routing table. Suppose if you take this table, routing table at particular to this router, here 192.168.1, it is moving towards A direction. So that's why we are taking here as A. And then 210.15.15. So this is moving to B towards B direction, means interface B. Then 10 is to C, and 150.157 is D direction. So this will maintain this router. Assume that this is the source. Assume this is the source and this is the destination. You want to send some data. You want to send some data from here, from this system to this system. You want to send data. So system will prepare content. So in this is the data part. Then you have to give the source address and destination address. So source address you are sending from this system, so you have to add your own address. So this is source ID, and then you have to add to whom you want to send. This is simply like from address and to address in case of postal system. So here 10.1.1.1. So this is the content, whatever be the you want to forward to this one. So this is prepared at here. So they assume that this packet is reached to this router. Then how it will decide the route? So for that it will use this table. Now it will this is the destination ID part. So it will take the source ID part, so it is coming from there. Then it will take the destination ID part. See here, very importantly, see 10.1.1. This is 10. This is by seeing this is the total address. So in this you have the two parts as we discussed, network ID and host ID. So network ID, to know the network ID, first you have to know this is belongs to which class. So we are taking the first octant and this is the 10. So this range will comes under which class? So this will comes under class A. So by using class A, you have to extract, ultimately you have to extract the network portion so that you can compare here and to which it is, so that you can know that which direction you have to forward. So that's why you are finding the range, then you are finding the class, then you are extracting network portion. Now with this it will compare in the routing table. So 10 here C, then it will forward to direction C, then it will reach here. This is abstract level. This is the discussion about how one system will send the data to the destination by using router table and how router will behave. So this is something about this one. Assume that your destination address something like which is not there inside in among these four. Suppose destination address is something 130.5.10.15. So while seeing the destination, after seeing the destination address, you have to extract the network portion. So this is the 130. So this belongs to class B. Then in class B, you for network portion, you have the you are using first two octants. So these two will become the network ID. So 130.5 is network part. So here one that with this you will compare, you will look in a routing table. So but this 130.5 is not exist in this router table. So what we have to do is every router will maintain one default route. That default route is the anyone. So every router will maintain one default route. That default route is any immediate router, so neighbor router. So assume that in this case, assume it is forwarding C direction. So in this network also you have one more router. So this is also, as we discussed while discussing postal network, each village have one post office. Like each network have one router, local router. So it will come here and its routing table, it will look for same thing. Then if it is exist, it will consume and it will submit to the particular system in that network. If it is not exist in the routing table, it will forward to its default route. Same like here, it will select its default route and then it will forward. So this is the actual thing, how in simply we can say this is how router and how the one system will send the data from source to destination.